I'm with San Diego State coach, Hall of Famer Tony Gwynn, and I want to first thank you for giving me your time here today.
No problem, thank you.
And as a hitting instructor, one of the easiest things for me to do is teach the mechanics of hitting.
Right.
That's the easy part. The hardest part is what I think made you one of the greatest hitters in the game.
Thank you.
Was the approach to hitting.
Yeah.
And I'm going to step away, and I want you to explain what you need to do when you step into that box and where your mindset needs to be.
Okay. Well, it took a little while to kind of figure it out, but I think early on in my career, I kind of established, okay, what type of hitter I am, what am I trying to do when I get up to the plate, and what I learned was I'm a contact hitter. I'm not a guy who's going to hit the ball out of the ballpark, and so my goal is to go up to the plate and put the bat on the ball, pure and simple. I had no preconceived notions of where I wanted to hit it. I just knew that for me, what I did best was hit the ball the other way. And to me, that's the hardest part when it comes to hitting, is being able to stand here and let the ball travel and let it get deep. Because, well, right there, that's really where I made a living, right there, fastball away. And so I knew if I could handle this ball right here was going to be easier to get to. And it's all about hand position. And notice the hands, how when you go from away to in the middle to out in front, that the palm on the top hand is up. It's not going over. Because if it starts to go over, now I'm going to make a whole lot of outs, and I'm not going to be able to hit the ball as hard. And so I understood that if I got into a good position and if I took my hands on the right path throughout my swing, that I was going to have a chance for success. And that, in the game of baseball, is one of those little battles that you have to try to win, okay? We can't be so locked up on the result. We really have to focus on the process. And the process is, if I could go up to the plate and do things right every time, my chances of success go way up. So for me, it was understanding that I needed to control this ball out here first. If I could control this ball in the middle and this ball in the inside would be easier to hit. And that's who I was. That's what I tried to do. I tried to hit the ball. I tried to let it get deep as much as I could. Every now and then, you're going to take a shot. You're going to look for a ball in the middle of the plate. You're going to look for a ball in. But if I didn't get it where I was looking for, I would take it and try to work the camp to get to where I thought I knew what I was going to get. But ultimately, I wasn't a guess hitter. I didn't really anticipate a whole lot. I just kind of trusted my eyes and trusted if I got my hands in the right position that I could hit it. And ultimately, I learned that if I could handle the ball away, I could handle the other two zones a whole lot easier. And so I really focused on trying to command the fastball, or trying to command the outer third of the plate, because if I could control that, I can control the other two thirds. And it really got to the point where I could go up to the plate and not really look for anything other than something out over the plate and still be able to handle balls middle and in.